I'd like to say thank you to our new subscribers who have come to us from Long Island Bigfoot's channel. Your support means so much. We've also got some new subscribers from Dark Hour Paranormal. Thank you for joining us as well. If you're not subscribed to Dark Hour Paranormal, please go over there and check it out. You can find the recent episodes where I was on the program sharing some of my photos and talking about my thoughts on elementals and the forest people. This was originally a slideshow I uploaded before I started a channel. It was taken along the Neosho River on a nature and bike mountain biking trail. This would have been 2 weeks after the late summer Squatch video in September. It is a small nature trail about 1.3 miles in length out and back. The halfway point would have been a little over 0.6 of a mile. The first thing I noticed about this trail was that there are blinds everywhere, similar to those in other places. It was quite dark despite it being late morning or early afternoon. As I walked back, I was excited with the possibility that this was an active location based on what I was seeing. And these tangled vines and trees were everywhere too, which was really cool. I think it's a home for the elementals. There was a little swinging bridge that connected to the back part of the trail, and this was sort of an island area. This was on the right back here. It was very dense. And I feel like there were forest people in there. The trail continued on the left side along the river. And you can see here some pictures along this creek where it flowed into the river. And this area, like I said, back here on the right was just very, very dense. You couldn't even penetrate it. There was no way. So this area was probably pretty well protected, and it looks like there's some elementals here in the river, as well as maybe some forest people hiding in the shrubs on the left side. I noticed these different colored flowers. They were red, yellow, and purple along the trail, kind of just in this one section right here, and I thought they were kind of pretty, so I took a picture of them. This to me just looked like a Sasquatch seat. Some of these tangles and clusters just did not appear natural to me. They looked like they had been placed there. And there are places along the trail where you just feel walled in by the blinds and by the structures. Here you can see some more elementals in this tree. And there's something there circled at the lower part. I'm even not even sure what that is. I think it may be one of those rods, but I know a lot of people are going to say, well, it's a caterpillar or some kind of insect or something, but it just looks kind of strange the more I look at it. I thought this was funny. There's a trash bag draped over a tree limb, and it's about 7 feet at least off the ground. I don't think I could have thrown it over there, draped it over that limb like that, but what struck me as odd about this is there was a lot of trash from the mountain bikers, and I was wondering if it was Bigfoot's hint to the mountain bikers that they needed to pick up their trash. This is getting into an area where it's looking really squatchy along the trail. There's tree structures everywhere, and it almost appears as if there are barricades. The way they've got it barricaded off with the limbs. Some of these tree structures here are actually really cool. They seem to be making patterns, like stars or whatever, using the natural environment. I thought this was interesting. Though this area is not very wide or very big, there are miles and miles of agricultural fields right behind it. So here they could easily have access to food such as corn and other crops. There was a little creek that was cutting through the land and flowing into the river. And here on the opposite bank, you could see this hole. It was a pretty big hole. It looked like some kind of den for something, but it was a pretty good size. So I don't know what could be living up in there. After I reached the end of the trail and turned around and started to return, I came across the swinging bridge. There is a tractor trail that runs to the water there from the agricultural fields. And I walked down to the water. At that point, I started hearing birds chatter. I started walking back up the cart path towards the trail, and I noticed that there were birds gathering in the trees everywhere. They were calling and squawking. It just seemed like they were calling in more birds. At this point, the wind had picked up, and it was about 90 degrees. I started feeling a cool breeze on me. The air felt kind of electric. Are charged at this point, and I felt like something was happening. I didn't know if that was what was causing the birds or because the birds were stirring up, but it just felt like it had started to get intense. As I'm walking, I start walking back down the path, going back the way that I came, and all these birds are around me in the trees above me, and I can hear them calling, and it just seems like there's more and more birds coming everywhere. And at this point, I'm starting to think, okay, are these birds following me? Are they going to follow me back? Or are they escorting me out? And that was indeed what seemed to be happening. The birds were following me and going from tree to tree just ahead of me. Like I said, more and more birds showed up. I felt like I was being swarmed by these blackbirds, and they were escorting me out. At that point, I had chills in 90-degree summer weather from whatever it was that was causing these birds to do this, and I felt like I was having an encounter with something. I would add my thoughts on being swarmed by blackbirds, that there was a connection to the feather that was given to me in another location a couple weeks before that. As I'm walking along, I'm also wondering, are the birds going to follow me back to this one spot in particular where it looked really squashy? And I felt like maybe they were close by or something. I didn't see anybody there at the time, but there was some really dark places there in the woods and in these along these structures. It just seemed like they could be close by, and especially with everything that was happening, I felt like something, at least spiritual or supernatural, was happening. Again, I'm noticing these flowers here. They're yellow and blue, and there are some flowers that have been cut or pulled laying right beside it, beside the trail. And I didn't notice that on the way in. Now, maybe I didn't see it, but it was just odd because I had noticed the flowers going in, and then on the way out, there was flowers laying alongside the trail. And this got my attention right away. Right beside the trail was this broken piece of bamboo. Looked like it was snapped in two almost, but not completely, to where the top part's bending over. It had been shoved into the ground, and I actually pulled it out of the hole to see, you know, that it was actually stuck, that there was a hole in the ground, and you can see that, and then I placed it back in the hole. And this, to me, was the forest people giving me a sign that they were there. This was a very shamanic experience for me, with the birds and encountering the forest people in this location. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe, and ring that bell icon for notifications. Thank you.